Well, I'm not going to do a Hayfield Follies 2015 series. However, I am going to show you the rake repair that we do. We're over here at Professor Grumpy's House of Mayhem Miracles.
And this is how the rake decided to break last year. But I was almost done, so I figured, or it figured, I was done. So we got to fabricate new housing for the bearing. And the shaft isn't exactly straight. Oh, the things we have to do.
So while Professor Grumpy's out fixing something at the laundromat, this is the piece we need for fabricating the housing for the bearing. So I'm going to burn up a half an hour's worth of battery and memory on the camera. Ready? Go! Mention I'm using an anemic chop saw to do it. What's happening?
I wish I knew.
Professor Grumpy's back from the laundromat. He's got my broken part over there. Thinks he can fix it. How are we gonna do it?
I can.
I can do anything.
Give me the material. I can do it.
You are strong. You are invincible.
No, I'm not strong.
You are
I'm
woman.
Tired.
You are woman. Okay, what are you going to do now?
Okay,
we're going to make... You found a shaft that'll fit in that thing, but we're not going to use that thing. So what are you going to do after that?
Where's your...
My...
The shaft and device grips on it.
It was over there.
Well, I walked away again.
When I left here, it was over there. So...
It walked away.
It's three-quarter
inch. I want that shaft.
Where did you put it?
All right, here, we have a good shaft. We need two more.
Yes.
We got to replace them and make them out of Buick long neck water pumps. Make two new shafts.
Okay.
Three. We need three, don't we?
We need three total, but you have a good one in your vice grips.
Okay, so we're going to make two new ones out of Buick long neck water pumps.
Okay.
So.
What are you going to put it in?
Oh. I'll bore this out and put it in there.
That sounds boring.
Pardon me?
That sounds boring.
I know it is boring.
Okay.
Okay, so here we have the broken part with a three-quarter hole in it. We're going to replace it with this metal bushing. I tried to, or will, machine this down so I don't have to bore this hole out too far. And I will end up with a nice thick wall. We're going to bring the shaft down to a diameter of 0.670 and then bore the bushing out to fit the shaft. So that is finished. So now we're going to bore this out so this will fit right in it. We need to make it look like this. Fit to both ends of the shoulder, and we're done. Okay, one shaft ready, machined. So now we can put a die on it and thread it. Thank you for your attention. going to work on the next one.
What'd you come up with?
Now we have here the new shaft, the old shaft, shoulder length perfect, within 10 thousandths. Like it?
Yeah.
You better, because that's all you get.
1946.
Well, this is out of a 50. The shaft is out of a 59 Buick, non-air.
We've upgraded.
Yeah. See, in this way, we have a nice heavy wall for welding.
So this, yeah, okay, this is going to be our repair.
Right, correct.
So,
this is the repair project.
Did you make one more of these?
What, a shaft?
Yeah.
I can make two more.
One more. I have one.
I asked you a minute ago.
How many do we need?
How many do we need?
Total.
Correct.
One.
No, two.
This is number one. That's number two. How many's left to make?
I don't know. That's
three minus two is?
So, just one more.
Una más.
All right.
You done yet?
Almost.
Okay. Well, after an hour later, it's been about an hour, hasn't it?
Something like that.
You did put the blade on the right direction, didn't you?
High because you break the blade.
Yes, Father.
Well, it ain't my fault you call me the professor.
Professor Grumpy.
No.
Professor Cranky.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey.
Yes?
We can do it 5 times faster if we put it up on the hoist and then put it at work level.
Yeah?
Yeah.
The only reason I'm doing it is because he's not going to stop bugging me until we do that.
So, let me put some air
in it. But it only weighs 250 pounds.
It's okay. We can do it. Hang on.
So, you may ask, why don't you just use a bandsaw? Because the bandsaw is broke. That's why.
Come on, muscles.
Now, why didn't you leave that down so we can just only pick it up 3 inches and set it on it and then use the hoist to lift it?
That's a little too high. Should have left it on then. That way we could have picked it up easier.
I don't know what your body's like, but I know what my body's like. My body ain't carrying this from there to there.
Between the two of us, we could have done it.
Yeah. I could be up all night, but it hurts back.
Want it
all the way down?
Yeah.
Yeah, one side. Okay,
do
one side.
Okay.
Done?
I'm done. Wow.
I like that better. Hey, is the MG for sale?
Yeah.
How much?
For the two of them, $1,000.
Market a bargain. Two for one. $1,000.
That one has a complete engine transmission, new clutch, yada, 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 yada.
And you get the bonus, yada, yada. Why are you putting pressure on the back? Oh. That's what wears out your blade. Done yet?
Almost. Probably tomorrow.
Thank you. See you tomorrow.
Good idea. Yeah, I know what's wrong. Hey.
Yeah, your bandsaw's broke. That's what's wrong.
No, that's the left hand of the hacksaw. Not for right-handed people.
Well, that's why I'm doing it left-handed.
Ah.
This works better now. Look at that. quarter inch to go. What's he gonna bring back now? Big hammer, knock it off of there. It's in 3, 2, 1.
Okay, so it's the next day. So before we go in the shop, he said these MGs are for sale. $1,000, both cars. Let's see what you get here. Not too terribly bad. No rust to speak of. Top's actually in decent shape. What ho, engine parts. I know nothing about these cars. I'm glad I said it was an MG and not a Triumph. Looks like the seats are in good shape except for the parts laying on them. 4-speed. Crack dash. Glass is all good. Looked like this one got redone and never assembled. And then somebody decided to do this to it. Brilliant! Yeah, there's some body work in here. But, as I said, no rust really to speak of. What year is it? I don't know. What model is it? I don't know. Oh, it's locked. Spare hood, maybe? Oh, that's from the other car. Well, front suspension's kind of discombobulated. Unit number 2. Could have at least put the top up over it so it didn't get winterized. Let them their fancy wheels go with it. Well, there you go. Need a couple MGs or parts? $1,000 both cars. ElderlyIron.com. See ya. What was wrong with the laundromat?
I don't know.
You got there, everything was okay?
No.
You turned the breaker off, turned it back on, everything was okay?
No, well, yes and no. She did. While I was on the phone, she threw the breaker on the 80 amps out there, the one where you repaired.
Yeah.
And it still didn't do it. And she opened up the fuse box in the foyer, and she had a weird smell over there. And she blew through the breaker, still nothing happened.
They're supposed to do that outside, though. Had a weird smell over there. They're supposed to do that outside.
I don't...
Never mind.
So anyhow, it walked away.
It's 3/4
I want that shaft.
Where did you put it? Are the vice grips still with it?
Yeah. Last time I found it on here.
I didn't put it there. I see a pair of ice grips. Those aren't mine.
And who put this back on here? I threw it down there.
I did.
I threw it down there. Leave it there.
I had to film it.
I don't want it. Okay. Camera on. Going.
You're the star.
All right. Here, we have a good shaft. I know it is, but...
Mind the way yet?
No, you're not in my way. Yes, you're in my way. Get something done out there. So I can get something done.
You weren't on camera for all that. Okay, you're the star of the show.
Thank you.
I'm going outside.
Bye.
The camera's right there. If you want to say something, look at it.
Man, what did you eat?
Wash it again. There it is.
Back up. Don't fall over.
So,
what'd you come up with?
Now we have here the new shaft, the old shaft.
One.
All right, let's clean up.
You gonna leave that on the lift?
Yeah.
Okay. That's entertainment.